Hey guys,
and welcome back to our channel from Two Brown Girls. I'm Isolita.
I'm Brittany DeReese.
And today we're going to discuss having different names. A lot of stars have decided to name their kids not your normal Ashley's, Brittany's, or anything like that. Right. So just discussing how they have decided on those names, and are they setting their kids up for success, if you will?
Yeah, so I think the spark of this topic was Cardi B and Offset welcomed their daughter on July 10th, and they named her Culture Kahari?
Yeah, Culture with a K.
Yeah, Culture with a K. Which I'm like, that's not really bad. I could kind of live with it. It's not my fave. What do you think?
I mean, I don't have the most common name, so
you know.
So I think that it's different, but I mean, I think even though like their daughter's probably going to be, you know, in the spotlight somewhat
by
because
force,
their parents
yeah.
are. So even like your Northwest and your Saint West and like Kim Kardashian's kids, and they have like different names.
Yeah. The only one of those their kids out of all three of them that I actually like the name is Chicago West.
I do like that.
I feel like that one has a meaning. He's from Chicago. That's where his roots are from. Mm-hmm. But like Northwest, I absolutely think was probably like one of the hideous names I've ever heard of. Like if her last name wasn't West to me,
maybe it
would make
different.
Yeah, but it just was too far off. Like I actually like Jay-Z and Beyonce's daughter's blue name.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about it?
I like it. I think that it does have some meaning behind it.
Yeah.
The Rumi and Sir kind of threw me off a little bit,
yeah.
though.
Maybe if they shared the meaning to me, that would make more sense.
Maybe.
But right now, I don't. What does that mean?
No one knows.
Why is he named Sir Carter? We know he's a sir. He's a boy.
Have you ever, like, being that your name is Brittany, have you ever... had someone, whether it was like stereotype or already try to say like who you were or like what you look like or anything like that?
No, I think for me, my last name is Dunlap, so it is not a common like Caucasian name. It's not a common last name, period, but I don't think people assume that it is a Caucasian name. And then also the way my name is spelled, most Brittany's that are Caucasian spell it like Spears. So I often...
I didn't even realize that.
Yeah, like all of the white Britneys I know are like Spears, and so most black ones are the A and Y. So I haven't really got that, but then again, I wouldn't know.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I'm pretty sure with your name, Isolita, people automatically assume
I'm
your
Spanish.
Ethnicity. Yeah,
I'm Spanish, and then they pronounce it Isolita, which is really how it's pronounced, but I mean, we Americanize it, obviously.
Yeah.
But I think that having a name, like, sometimes people just automatically like stereotype anything
yeah.
that they hear, and I think that it can be a setback. Like you can either set your children up for one thing
yeah.
or another.
Well, I think, but then think about it though, like have you felt like with your name being unique that you have lost opportunities because of your name? I think maybe if this was like the 50s and
mm-hmm.
people were naming their kids these funky names, and it may have been like a little side-eye-ish, but even then, I have an aunt, her name is Bridgette. It's not Bridget, it's not this, we don't pronounce it the same,
mm-hmm.
it doesn't have the D in it, but people know that that's her name, and I don't think she's ever lost any opportunities. Probably not a good example, but
mm-hmm.
she's older than us.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever lost any opportunities. I think it's just, there's always a story behind it for me, of like, oh, that's a very pretty or unique name.
Yeah.
How did you get that name? So, just having us being able to like share that story with people and kind of like, educate them, if
yeah.
you will, of like the meaning behind it
yeah.
and like why it's important and all of that stuff. So
yeah, see, for me, I always ask, where did Brittany come from? And
mm-hmm.
no one can tell me. Like, no, I'm not able to pinpoint. And also, my middle name is Darice. No one has any idea where Darice came from. Like, and it's so odd because I don't have a story. I'm like, I don't know. They just
named me Brittany.
Wrote it on a birth certificate, and here I am. I guess it was just popular back then.
Yeah.
So.
I think it was because even when
yeah,
I was in college, I knew a lot.
And I hate that. I hate that. This
mm-hmm.
is why, like, my handle and even how I intro myself here is Brittany DeReese,
mm-hmm.
just to have some uniqueness to me.
Mm-hmm.
At least I'm not, like, Brittany Ashley or Brittany Crystal or Brittany Nicole. At least I do have some unique element because
yeah.
I'm not like everybody. Right. Girl. Send me to you a little different. Like, geez. But yeah. So another celebrity name. I love them. I love Tiny. Love T.I. But Eris Harris. What?
I think it just sounds like super close.
Yeah.
That's like John Johnson or something. You know what I mean? Like, it's just super
too close. I love the first name if it was her last name wasn't Harris. So maybe once she gets married, but like she's like two.
Yeah.
So she has years to deal with her last name being Harris.
Right. And Pharrell Williams and his wife, they named their son Rocket. It's actually Rocket Air Williams.
Like my thing is, what does that mean? So I have a younger cousin whose name is Dorje, who actually like helped us with this topic. So
thanks. Shout out to Dorje.
Right. But her name has meaning. It sounds initially ghetto, but her grandmother, our grandmother, name was Dorothy, so she has a D-O-R from our grandmother, and then her dad's mom name was Janita, or Jeanette. Something like that. Sorry. So they combined the first two letters of both of her grandmother's name and made Dorje. So I get the meaning. So to me, even if you have a unique name, if it has like a meaning, I feel like people can understand that. But if you're just walking around naming your kid Saint West and you ain't a saint, I'm confused. Like, I just don't get it. Like, but who am I? I mean, the child doesn't have anything to do with, like, being named that way.
But if you guys have heard anything of any, like, different names, or if you have a unique name, let us know down in the comments.
And also tell us what it means. Like,
yeah, I think that's important. Like, you have to give some background, or, like, how you got that name.
Or how you're naming your children, rather. Because, like, you may not have a background, like, I don't, but you do. But if you have kids, or if you have a name that you want to name your kids, tell us what that is, and, like, why?
Yeah.
I'm struggling with the why today.
Well, I think it, like, just depends. Like I was named after both of my grandmothers, too. So my first name, Isolita, like, the fourth generation of Isolitas. And it's a Belizean name, so that's why I was named that. And then Elizabeth is my middle name, which is kind of like Isolita. Elizabeth's completely different.
Yeah, but like mine, Brittany Dereese, so we basically swapped.
We swapped, yeah. So I was named after my other grandmother, so.
Got it.
Yeah, that's just kind of how it happened. And even like my mom's, like a funny story, my mom told my dad that she was going to let him name me.
Ah, so that didn't work out?
No, not at all. He wanted to name me, like, Nicole or something. And so it was like,
it's a super common name.
But I don't look, to me, at least, like a Nicole.
No.
And so my mom was like, yeah, you can name her, sure, go ahead. And when I came out, she was like, just kidding.
Change her mind. My mom was going to name me Amber. And I don't have a knock on Amber. I have a good friend named Amber. But I don't think I'm an Amber.
Yeah.
But I also don't think I'm a Brittany either.
But I think you grow into your name.
True.
Like, I think you grow into it, and it's like, yeah, I couldn't see you as anything else.
Like, you being anything other than Isolita doesn't even seem, like,
not at all
close.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do definitely grow into your name. Mm-hmm. As a kid, I was like, there are no grandma Brittanys. I was really like,
wait, what?
Think about that. Like, think about your name and how it is, like, a common name, like, in the 80s. Mm-hmm. There was no Grandma Brittany. So, for me as a child, I was like, literally, like, I need to change my name. It doesn't fit. Like, Brittany doesn't think about that. There is no, like, 50-year-old Brittanys. Imagine
this is true.
Grandma Brittany. That doesn't even sound right. Like, my grandkids are going to have to name me something else.
Auntie Brittany.
Like, that doesn't even flow. Like, it feels like I'm going to be a teenager forever.
That's a good thing.
I hope.
No, black don't cry, girl.
Ow! Well, guys, that is all that we have for you today. So be sure to like and subscribe. The bell will be somewhere below, as Isolita always tells you guys. But please leave us a comment and let us know what you think about today's video.
Bye, guys.
Bye.